Hey guys, how you doing? This is Benjamin with Benjamin's Exotics, and I hope this shot's good because I just carried this whole rack up a set of stairs, up another set of stairs, and then I found out that the lighting up there wasn't the best, so I had to carry it back downstairs. So, if this shot doesn't come out very good, in terms of lighting and everything, kind of not my fault. I couldn't really find a good place for it to be lit, except for this is probably the best I could find. But really quickly, before we get into the video and I'll show you guys the new rack I just got, I wanted to give a quick, you know, I guess you could call them shout-outs to a few people that have been commenting pretty, you know, pretty good on this channel, and just a few things that I thought should be addressed in terms of our subscribers, because we have some of the best subscribers on YouTube, at least in my opinion, from what I've seen. So, well, we've got a few people right now. Phone Man, Matthew Chernensky, I'll say his name just because he's already got it in the comments and stuff like that. A few others, Masco Rambo, I might have butchered that. He seems to be pretty into leopard geckos. He's also got some pretty cool dancing videos and things like that. If you guys want, you can go check his channel out and definitely subscribe to his channel if you guys want. But the main guys right now are Masco Rambo. If I butcher your name and you're watching this, sorry. You know, my pronunciation isn't always the best. Matthew Chernensky and a Phone Man. Phone Man is commenting on, like, every single video I put out. Literally, I was sitting down the other day. I had a video up for 4 minutes, and he commented on there. So either he's just insane sitting behind a computer the whole day, or he's really dedicated and liking the content, which is good. I like when people like this content. So definitely you can go check their channels out. Phone Man's channel is definitely a little bit different and interesting. Definitely interesting in some of the stuff he's got on his channel. He doesn't have a, you know, a crap ton of videos, but you should go definitely check him out. And Matthew Kuninsky's got some cool stuff on cars. But before I ramble on too long, let's get straight into this video, which is the rack system I picked up at the Reptile Expo. Now, I got this rack, tubs and all, for about $75, and that's about as much as it would have cost me to build this rack. These guys, either, I don't know, they just couldn't sell this rack or whatever, but basically, I don't want to say I got a steal on this rack, but it would have probably cost me $65 to make, and I got it for $75. These tubs have been used a little bit, I guess, I don't know, don't look very used to me. They've got, you know, just some little holes drilled in the side, and you can kind of see in there. They're just Sterilite tubs, nothing special. 41 quart, kind of what I already have used for ball pythons in the past. And the only reason I've got this is a few things. Number one, I've got some snakes like my Pastel Adult, 66% chance Het for Lavender Albino, not the other pastels that I've got. And a spider ball python male that I've got. There's just a few snakes. I don't know about the male. He might be actually a little bit too on the small side, I guess, to go in a rack like this. But we'll see. We'll see once we get everything sorted out, once I actually get the heat tape in this thing. Because that's the one thing it didn't come with. It didn't come with heat tape. But it came with the racks and the material and everything. And it's built really good. Like, it doesn't wiggle at all. It's solid. So, besides that, this is basically the rack. It's three slots high, so it'll hold three breeder female ball pythons. And I've talked to before about racks versus tubs. And you know what? It really is, when it comes down to it, up to the snake. Some snakes can be in tanks. They don't care about being shown off or being displayed. Okay, that's fine. If those snakes like that, then I'll give it to them in the form of a tank. But if those snakes are a snake that is always hiding, always seems stressed out, always seems, you know, just to be not having the best time or having, you know, the best comfort in its living quarters, you know, basically it's rack or tub in a home. Oh my gosh, that chair just almost fell over from the wind. Before I get too sidetracked, basically, I give the snakes what they're telling me. You have to be able to read your snakes. If a snake is hiding all day, if it doesn't like lights, if it's always trying to be as dark as possible, always hiding its head, then I'm going to know that that snake might be more of a snake for a rack. It'd be a snake in the wild that would not come out very often. It'd be a snake that would stay in the burrows, try to go at night maybe, you know, when there's not many predators out. It's not going to be an outgoing snake. In the wild, that could be a good thing or bad thing. I really don't care because we're, you know, in captivity. I don't want to say, you know, I don't care to be too abrupt, but it doesn't really affect me in captivity. It's just what the snakes prefer, what's in their, you know, their likes, I guess you want to call it. So The only reason I got this is because I do believe that I have a female pastel, especially that even though these tubs are a little bit big, and the tubs are actually, they move pretty far in the rack, so the tubs aren't actually as huge as that rack looks. They're actually a little bit smaller than that, and they go in pretty far. But with this is about the size of a 20-gallon that she's in right now, and I think with the darker environment, I'll still take her out. I don't like having snakes in the dark. I'll still take her out, you know, at least once a week to make sure all my snakes are nice and handleable, because in the summertime, we go out and we get, you know, a little kids from the community and stuff like that, and we'll do little reptile, I guess you want to call them, little shows, mini shows. We'll just bring out, like, you know, any the biggest snakes we've got. All the little kids from the neighborhood come down. Sometimes they'll ask, you know, some kids, if they're my parents, let them. I always ask first if they can have a, you know, a snake shed, and we'll get some of our best snake sheds and give them to the kids. And hey, some of those kids will grow up, you know, to be, you know, 7, 8. I don't really recommend it at that age, but, you know, 10 years old and stuff, and then they'll get into reptiles, and it'll be a passion of theirs. So it's good to grow the community. But besides, if I don't get too sidetracked, basically, the reason I got this rack is because I got some snakes that I believe will do better in this than others. Obviously, I can easily overfill this rack. I've got plenty of snakes that are big enough to go in this thing. My adult male, Zucchini, he will never go in a rack system in his whole life unless it's dire, like, his health is really going to be hurt if he doesn't, because he's done good in a glass tank for his whole life. He'll stay in there, but for any bigger breeder females that are having problems and won't do so good in tanks, this is where they'll be going. Some people might say it's mean, some people might say it's cruel to keep them in this, but remember, in the wild, there's going to be two types of ball pythons. One of them is going to be outgoing, going out through the grasses, maybe a little bit in the trees, and those do get picked off more than the other ones, probably, in some cases. And then the other ball pythons, completely different, completely introverts, will stay in their holes in the ground that they make, or steel rodent holes, or termite mounds, all kinds of stuff. You can just watch the videos. Some ball pythons even love to swim. Some ball pythons, you know, just, oh my gosh, there's so much variety in ball pythons. This is going to become a completely different video from what I was saying, but if you guys are still watching on this video in a second, you don't have to listen to me ramble on too long, but seriously. Ball python personalities, some ball pythons love to climb. I have a Mojave ball python. She's outgoing, not afraid of anything, loves to climb. Oh my gosh, she loves to climb, basically. It's just, it's crazy. She wouldn't do very good in the wild. She'd climb up, you know, as a baby, maybe not as her size now, of course, but as a baby, bird would come by, ooh, look at that little worm, and come down and grab her. Not the best thing. But since she's in captivity, she can do what she likes, and she doesn't have to worry about it. Okay, some other snakes are like, holy crap, what's climbing? They just want to sit in their little holes the whole day in the darkness like these guys. And that's completely fine too. I'm going to offer both options to those snakes, because the happier they are, the happier I are, because the happier I am, because the less health problems they're going to have, and the better they're going to feed if I ever breed them, and all that kinds of stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This video turned into more of a all kinds of different things, and I'll probably try to put that and fit that in the description. But I really wanted to show you guys this rack. I picked it up at the expo. We'll see if we can get some snakes filled into this soon. I still got to quarantine some other snakes that I've got, and I have a boa over there. I'll try to show you. You can't really, yeah, it's kind of a mess in there with all the decorations and stuff. But I got a boa that I'm still trying to, I'm going to get him a bigger cage soon. But as I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If anything that I said in this video, I kind of rambled on a little bit, but if you watched till the end, good on you. You're definitely absorbing all the information you can on these snakes, which is very good if you're trying to get a pet or if you already have a pet. We always want to offer the best care to these animals possible. But as I've already said, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button if you like this video, and I will see you guys in the next video.